Geometrically, it is clear why a set of two vectors is dependent if and only if one of the vectors is a multiple of the others. But can you prove this rigorously? Well, give it a try and see in this video whether you did it correctly. So, what do we have? A set of two vectors, V2 in Rn, and the statement is that it is linearly dependent if and only if one vector is a multiple of the other. Well, the most dangerous step, the most important step to note is that you actually have to prove two things, two implications, that implication and that implication. This implication says, well, if one of the vectors is a multiple of the other, then the set S is dependent. And the other one says, if S is dependent, then one of the two is a multiple of the other. So that's step zero, split into two parts. We'll do this one first. So given is that one of the vectors is a multiple of the other, and without loss of generality, you can assume that it is the second one to be a multiple of the first one. Why can you assume that without loss of generality? If it would be the other way around, just switch them out in your starting set. Then you have to prove that this equation over here only has a non-trivial solution. That's what it means, that S is dependent. So how do you prove that? Well, you start with this equation over here, and you bring the V2 to the other side. Then you get the equation alpha times V1 minus V2 equals a zero vector. So that means that we have a non-trivial solution of equation star over here. Which one, by the way? We can conclude we have a non-trivial solution, so Rs is dependent. Now, go the other way around. Given that we have a non-trivial solution of this equation over here, then we have to prove that one of the vectors is a multiple of the other. Now, we know that we have a non-trivial solution, so either C1 is non-zero or C2 is non-zero, or both. Well, without loss of generality, we assume it's the first one, otherwise you can do the same argument, but just reverse the roles of C1 and C2. So we assume C1 to be non-zero. Then we can solve for V1. By the way, why do you need here that C1 is non-zero? You need it here, so notice why. We can solve for V1. We see that it is a multiple of C2. And then we can conclude that indeed, if S is dependent, then the one vector is a multiple of the other. Now, this theorem also holds for larger sets. So, given a set of 3, 4, 5 vectors, do you also have in that case that the set is dependent if and only if one of the vectors in the set is a multiple of the others? Well, I hope you said no here, because this is a very dangerous one. The theorem does not hold for larger sets. If none of the vectors in a larger set is a multiple of the others, you still do not know whether the set is dependent. If one of them is a multiple of the others, you are done, you are fine, but it's unfortunately often used incorrectly the other way around. So don't do that. If you have a larger set, even though none of the vectors is a multiple of the others, you still do not know whether your set is dependent or independent.